This is the DS1000 Digital Storage Oscilloscope series by Axiomet. The DS1052 and DS1100 are two-channel entry-level benchtop oscilloscopes that ideally serves educators, R&D engineers, and manufacturing engineers. First, let's go through a few quick specs on both models and then have a deeper look at other features. Visually, they are almost the same. They have the same dimensions, weight, a big 7-inch LCD display, Kensington lock, and other I/O interfaces. However, DS1100 have a slight advantage with 100 MHz bandwidth, overall memory depth of 2 megapoints, and sampling rate of 1 giga samples per second. Both come with a manual, two passive probes, mains cable, a calibration certificate, EasyScope software, and a 1-year warranty. To make sure your measurements are precise, check if the probes are properly compensated. To do that, connect the probe to the compensation terminal at the front panel and use the non-metallic driver so the signal is as close to a perfectly compensated signal as possible. On the vertical section, each channel is controlled individually, which allows easy access to its menu and other settings. To turn on the channel and access its menu, press the middle button. As you can see, channel's one menu bar appeared on the screen. The designated menu on-off button allows you to close any menu and have a better and wider view of the signal. The intensity adjustment knob to its right has universal properties and is used to change settings in other menus. The menu gives you access to channel coupling, which can be DC, AC or ground, channel bandwidth limiting, which allows noise reduction and filters unwanted high frequencies, or change the vertical scale adjustment modes between coarse or fine. Coarse is defined as 1, 2 and 5 jumps, whereas fine has smaller step which can increase waveform's amplitude in between coarse jumps. You can also switch between the modes by pressing the volt division knob. Use the universal knob to set probe attenuation ratio between 0.1 and 10,000. On the second page, we can find the invert option and you can set a digital filter with the desired frequencies. On the last page, you can change volts to amperes or perform a skew correction. By pressing the math button, you get access to the math menu. The oscilloscope can perform 5 different operations, including addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and fast Fourier transform. In order to adjust mass waveform vertical positioning or its scale, go to the second page and use the universal knob. While in FFT, you can switch between channel 1 and channel 2 as the source. Switch between 4 window modes in order to reduce spectral leakage. You can also zoom into the FFT spectrum. Change the units between dB VRMS and VRMS and change FFT display between full or split screen for higher convenience. One more small option on the vertical section is the reference button. It allows you to save two waveforms from different sources and recall them later. To move waveforms vertical position across the screen, use the vertical position knob. To return the waveform to zero, simply press the knob. The horizontal knob allows you to adjust the horizontal time base of all channels and easy access to delay sweep state. You can also access the delay sweep function by pressing the menu button. In the horizontal menu, you can also choose between normal or long memory depth. The trigger level can be adjusted by the knob or can be quickly centered using the 50% button. In the trigger section, we can choose between 5 different trigger types. Each and one of them has its own options. You can also change the sources, define the type of the slope, and change the triggered mode. In the trigger setup menu, you can define the type of coupling or change the hold off time in case of complex waveforms. Turn on the noise reject function to reduce the possibility of noise coming from the trigger. It is also possible to complete the waveform acquisition using the force button, whether or not the oscilloscope detected the trigger. The DS1000 series oscilloscopes can acquire the signal in three different ways: sampling, peak detect, and average. In some cases, after the signal has been acquired, its waveform is bulky and has unrealistic shape. DS1000 series has the option to adjust it by using the dynamic sine interpolation function instead of the linear one. After signal acquisition, we can perform some measurements. First, we will cover the cursor menu and then the automatic measurements. There are three types of cursors to choose from: manual, in which the cursors are adjusted by the user with the universal knob; track mode, in which the cursor is following the signal; and automatic cursor, which works alongside with automatic measurements. Instead of adjusting the cursors, making measurements and counting the divisions on vertical and horizontal scale, one can easily get all the needed information about the waveform using the automatic measurements. Axiomet Oscilloscope can measure up to 32 different parameters by entering the individual menus or even display all the 32 measurements at once. In order to extract more information in a faster and more efficient way, press the auto button. The oscilloscope will automatically detect the optimal vertical and horizontal scales for both channels and will display a readable signal. Moreover, it can display just a single cycle over its rising or falling edges. In case you would like to get back to normal operation and discard your settings, the default setup button will restore it to factory configurations. In the utility menu, the user has access to system status, turn on off the beeping sound or the counter, and select a preferred language. In order to ensure top performance of the oscilloscope, the user can run self-calibration and test device's screen, keyboard, and LEDs. The user can also define how to use the back USB port depending on what is connected. If you are using the EasyShare software, select the USB TMC option and connect to the PC. If you have connected a printer and executed the printer function, select the printer option. If there is a new software available, the user can update the oscilloscope by inserting a USB flash drive into the front USB port and running the update by pressing the single key. Another very useful function of the oscilloscope is the pass-fail test. In this function, the oscilloscope monitors the signal and outputs a message if the signal does not match the predefined mask. In order to define the mask, first enable the test and go to the second page. Then in the mask settings, define mask margins on X and Y axis and press Create Mask. Other options include sound output in case of failure or even full stop of the test. You can also save the mask for future use in internal or external memory. It is advised to use the record option while capturing abnormal signals in the long term without keeping an eye on the screen. You can use the Save Recall menu to save and recall setups, waveforms, pictures, common delimited files, and factory settings to or from internal or external memory. For a quick printing or picture saving, use the Print button. If there are any doubts about functions or buttons, the oscilloscope has an online helper. Simply press the Help button and then any other key in order to get more information about its function. The DS1000 series entry-level oscilloscope by Axiomet are simple to use and yet contain smart analytical tools that will display and extract all the needed information from the signal.
You can find more videos on our channel.
Do not forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified when new ones arrive.